afternoon, America, and welcome to our broadcast of the 52nd Engineering Olympiad. I'm Andy Seifert, and here's my partner in crime, John Moore. John, how are we doing today?
Andy, that is an ongoing investigation. We swore we weren't going to say anything about that.
Right you are, John.
I just received word that our competitor this evening is heading down the ramp almost right now. Alex Jordan, a relative newcomer out of Purdue University, really made his mark at this year's Olympiad. Let's cut to video of that ramp. We've got Andy down on the field to interview our competitor, Alex Jordan. Let's go to Andy. Andy, how's it going down there?
Thanks, John. I'm down here on the field with Alex Jordan. Alex, how are you feeling today?
Feeling really good. Drank about 12 raw eggs this morning. So, tummy's all right. Good to go.
Impressive to hear. Now, Alex, you've already heard, but the judges have selected for you today a fluid dynamics problem for your competition. How have you prepared for this?
Well, you know, I've been to class for about 7 weeks now-ish. Might have missed a couple days. But I've been reading, and I'm looking to get a solid B, you know?
Yes, I do know. All right, Alex, good luck out there.
Thanks, Andy.
Now, John, we actually have some of his footage for his training regimen. Let's roll that. Welcome back, folks, and it's time to start our final competition. And the pressure inside the stadium is palpable.
And it is not just gauge pressure, Andy.
Right you are, John.
Earlier in this season, Alex Jordan has struggled a little bit with his integration techniques, but I'm really interested to see if he can maintain a steady flow from start to finish.
All right, let's go back down to the field for our final competitor.
Get it on!
And here we go. Just kicked off. Look at that stance. He is ready to take this problem head on.
Well, it looks like he's starting with the most logical step, drawing a diagram to help him out.
Excellent. Now, Alex definitely has some sharp drawing talent. We saw that earlier this year at the Invitational. Now, even though he is from Purdue, he is wearing a Rose Holman jersey to honor his brother, who was injured in a overthinking accident at Rose Holman earlier this year.
Now, John, look at this. He's defining his control volume very well in this problem.
Excellent. He really is controlling that volume, Andy.
Now, let's see where he goes from this.
Definitely labeling his diagram to make it easier for the judge to read. That is just going to score him brownie points.
I like this, adding the force in the y direction. It really is the only force we need to take into account in this problem.
Exactly. Seeing how the forces exerted by the jet that come out of the box only acts in the y direction. He is not even concerning himself with details that are not important.
Now, at this point, he's just copying down the conservation of linear momentum. I think that's the main principle required in this problem.
Definitely an excellent place to start. It is fairly straightforward, seeing as he only has to worry about two separate forces.
Now, let's see his first move. He takes the rho outside of the equation. That's good, because it's a constant. It's going to help him out a lot in the long run.
Definitely going to have less things to worry about inside the equation.
Now, what is he going to do with his velocity?
He has the V vector dotted within. Oh, he makes it squared. Because the velocity is acting perpendicular to the control surface, he can square the V terms.
That is a great move. Oh, and what's this? He has taken the H component out of the differential area. Since H is a constant, he only needs to worry about the X component.
So that's what he did right there, defining his velocity in terms of X with a slope of 50. Great move.
Good. Wow. This kid is sharp. Every time we see him, he never ceases to impress, Andy.
Now let's see what he's doing here.
Oh, here he goes. He's gonna square that. He's gonna go ahead and plug that equation in. Oh, it seems we made a little mistake here. We'll see if he catches it.
He's got my fingers crossed, John.
He's dropped the DX. That's a rookie mistake. Hopefully he catches it before the judge gets a hold of it. That could definitely cost him. Let's see where he's going now.
Oh, I think he's seeing something. Maybe taking a little pause to think.
Might see his mistake.
Maybe. Oh, no, he's down.
He's down. He is down. Let's go down to the field. Hopefully we have a camera on this.
Why?
Oh dear, it does not.
It hurts so
look
bad.
Good.
Okay, well, how about this?
Oh no, don't do that. No, stop. Am I gonna be able to play on
hopefully
it?
Hopefully everything
I think out. We can work something out.
Okay, good. It'll be all right.
All right, we'll get you all fixed up.
So he says poker, and then like, I go, but I don't even know her.
Welcome back, folks. It looks like Alex Jordan is trying to recover from his injury. You love to see such a great big heart in a game like this.
I haven't seen somebody come back from an injury like that since 68 in Helsinki during the Bernoulli incident.
It's too clear in my mind, John.
Who doesn't remember that? Our hearts go out to the family and friends of those competitors. Well, it does look like Alex is ready to start the game again, so let's go on down to the field.
How you doing, champ? Can you pull it off?
I think I can do it.
All right. Continue on.
Well, here we go again.
It looks like his first step. Oh, yep, he has caught his mistake. Great move.
Great, thorough work by the rookie. Hopefully he can play through this injury and get all the way to the end. It'd be a shame to watch him fail now.
No, I think he has all his components correct. I think all he has to do is some order of operations and he might have sealed himself the victory.
This is an exciting moment, Andy. A rookie has won the premier event at the Engineering Olympiad
now, John,
over a decade.
John, look at this. He's carrying his units all throughout the entire problem. It's great to see such thorough work. There's no way he's going to be able to mess up this unit at the very end.
This is great, great concise work by this rookie, Alex Jordan. All he's doing now is plugging in his numbers, and he might just be home free.
Here's the final calculation, John.
Oh, making sure his units are neat and tied up, not leaving anything to the imagination. That's going to score some points with the judge. Now, the judge today is Grant Canese. Notoriously difficult.
John, you could cut the tension with a chainsaw.
And he's got it.
Yeah!
Alex
he's
Jordan
got it.
Has done it. Amazing.
I'm the champion.
Wow, just wow, Andy. That kind of performance is the stuff of legends. They're going to be talking about that for years.
That's why I'm in this business, John, for times like this.
Well, I think we can all agree that was an incredible engineering Olympiad.
I think I could agree. Let's send it back to Professor Troy in the lecture hall. Good night, America.
And good luck.